worship here at Lighthouse Christian Community. I have a wife, her name is Gloria, and I have three kids. They're all grown up now. My concept of tithing changed radically soon after I got married. I quit my job at a Filipino-German company because of personal reasons, and I decided to try it on my own and business. Actually, before I got married, we had a house built. No, nung magawa yung bahay namin, obviously when you're having a house built on your own resources, with also with a little help from my parents, naubos talaga resources. Tapos nga, on the last day of work sa Telefunken, where I was working, where the Filipino-German company, that was the day that our first son was born also, by cesarean section. So all this add together actually depleted our resources quite a lot. It was difficult, and I realized it's not that easy going to business, no? So there were nights when, while praying with my wife, we would be crying, no? Asking God for provision, milk for our kids, food for the family. For a 50-month period, I tried my best to, you know, to get us going. Although my wife was still working with the company, it was not enough to carry us through, no? There were times when my father would just hand me some small amount of money. Sometimes he would ask me to bring home a kilo of shrimp na he bought from itinerant vendors, yung mga naglalako, no? Also, my father-in-law, no, he used to have to receive a sack of rice from his employment, and he would give us half the sack of rice, no? But all this we never asked from them. Hindi kami humihingi, no? We never told them our needs. Probably they feel some of them, or maybe God told them about it. No? I managed to get a refund from income tax. The refund was substantial, and actually was adequate for Gloria to be able to enroll in a review class for CPA. Throughout this period, we were listening to Christian Broadcast Station, DCAS, no, from Paris Broadcasting Company. And they had a program in the morning, I remember, and they had this byline that says, you can give without loving, but you cannot love without giving. No? Even during nung binata pa ako, we had that Christian station sa bahay namin dahil my mother is a Christian. What I learned throughout listening to the Christian radio from my parents also, I practice, no? Para bang na-inculcate sa mind ko that tithing is something that I have to do. No? But actually, it was even more than just tithing. No? It's out of gratitude, out of that sense of thankfulness to God. Na we were giving more. No? After 15 months of struggling, praying, a friend, a good friend, Angel Apoyan, notified me of an opening in the new division in their company, Deltron Automation. It fit my interest very much. I like it a lot, and I was accepted within the week. You know? When I first got to work, I was so grateful to God. No, I thank Him a lot. No, talaga bang sobra-sobra, no? Sobra ang gratitude ko for giving me that new opportunity. Anyway, yun nga, no? I learned that you have to give the first fruit. So yung first salary ko, I have to give it all. No? But then, of course, the first salary you cannot give it. No, you're behind so much in expenses. I actually was able to give the first fruit, the first salary amount, over a period of about 2.5 months. And all of the regular salary that I was receiving after that, I would give 10%. But actually, then it grew to more than that. No, because I was giving it not out of an obligation, but out of gratitude. No, my growth in that company was so fast. No, within the year, halos na doble yata or more than that ang sweldo ko. After that, we were able to start acquiring our own needs sa bahay namin. No, kasi when we had our house built, we never had our own appliances. Wala kami refrigerator. Yung pagka meron kami pagkain na pwede mapanis o isda, makikilagay kami sa kapitbahay namin. This is so good, no? So kain yung kapitbahay namin. No, pagka lulutuin na, kakato kami, pwede ho bang mabawi yung isda namin dyan, no? So it's so funny, but that's what life was, no? When we first got married. Yung mga furniture namin sa bahay, mga set, they were all donated by my sisters or brother or parents. Within 13 months, actually, I was able to buy a new car. When we managed to buy our own refrigerator, I remember the price was that 1,800 pesos. No? I would give a tithe out of it also, thinking that it's also an increase in our assets. Yung natatagiging asset namin sa bahay. No? The same way as I would treat a salary increase as an additional increase that God says you have to give the first of the first fruit, also you have to give of the increase. And I treated yung mga assets na na-acquire namin as increase, no, whether it's furniture, no, or whatever. So during that period, that's what our mode, no. So we're actually just so grateful to God for all the blessings na binibigay niya. Life is not always like that, no. So there came a period also na yung kumpanya namin experienced difficulty during the time of the Marcos crisis era. Yung kumpanya namin was actually close to hindi nakapagbayad ng mga sweldo, no? And come to think of it, na 9 months before that, I had company offers, no, from Intel, from Fairchild, na substantial offers that I turned down dahil out of loyalty to our company, no? Dahil I want to show that loyalty. Git pinapag-guilty pa ako ng presidente namin, no, na Jun, alis ka pa sa panahon na ito na medyo tagilid na tayo, things like that. But by around August, September that year, talagang we could hardly meet our salaries anymore in that company. No, sabi ko, sayang, no, why did I turn those jobs down, job offers down? And now here, God is closing the door on me. No? Then at that time, bigla ko nakatanggap ng call from yung boss ko in my first job, si Ernie Poblacion. Sabi niya, Jun, I have an opening in Singapore. You know, I'm looking for a guy who will manage it. Dahil he was now based in US, and they had a company there, and they wanted to set up a branch in Singapore. Sabi niya, can you manage it for me? No, nakontak niya ako. Because my previous job, I had a lot of troubles. And in one of those troubles, we came across each other, no, in California. And he saw me and managed to get in touch with me again. So a week later, no, around 10 days actually later, I was on the plane flying to Singapore. No? So sabi ko, when God closes one door, He's opening a window that is for better. No? After over a year in Singapore, I managed to bring my family with me. Nakasama ko na yun. I had 3 kids, no, si Trish, si John, si Karen. So we were now in Singapore. And then in a short while, nagkaroon din na recession. No? So a lot of unemployment happened in Singapore, and our company was not excluded. No? So we also experienced hardship in a foreign land. So it was even more difficult dahil I had nobody to turn to. Initially, I was asking our head office in US to provide for some of our financial needs. No? Eventually, they stopped providing for us. So what I did was, yung kinita ko, yung sinweldo ko, the savings that I had over the year and a half or so, I was putting back into the company, no? Para mapangsweldo ko yung mga sa mga tao namin. Dahil once you don't pay their salary, you practically close yung mga kumpanya dahil they won't report for work anymore. Pero behind kami, no, 4 months on rent, electricity, telephone, and even yung CPF nila, yung Provident Fund like our SS, which was substantial, about 50%, no? Of the total salary amount, we were not paying to the government. If anything happens, like mapadla ko pa sila namin for non-payment of rent, maputulan kami ng kuryente or whatever, our company will just close up and will be ala, no? So we have to come back. So ang natira lang talaga sa amin at that time was enough money para makabili ng ticket para makauwi kami. No? So we came back with some more money. We're in danger of coming back na wala kami kahit anong dala, no, except the whole family with us. At that time, merong crusade that was coming up in Singapore, no? Hindi ko exactly recall kung it was Luis Palau or Reinhard Bonnke, but I signed up in our church because I was attending the Wesley Methodist Church in Singapore. I signed up as counselor. I missed the briefing when the coordinator called me. June, did you get the briefing? I said, sorry, I missed it. Can you sign up for intercession? On my way to inside the church, habang papasok ako, the lady in charge, medyo nalate ako, was already praying. I remember her name was Susetta Ting, no? And she was praying, sabi niya, and prophesying, there's a man at my right, sabi niya ganun, your business is failing, but it won't fail, it will rise again. Eh, I was entering in that direction na tinuturo niya. Sabi ko, ako yun, that's me, no? So, ganun nga nangyari, no? Sabi ko, I claim it. And at that time also, although during the nights, we also struggled with my wife praying, asking God for provisions, no? Ang nangyari is, eventually, my wife suddenly realized, sabi sa akin, Dad, hindi mo napupuna. Every time we pray, every time gipit na tayo, every time na halos wala na, God provides, no? Kasi Singapore is not like us. When you receive a check, you can go to the bank and then cash it, no? So there are many, many times wherein at the day of payroll, bigla na lang may dadating na check sa amin sa noon time, and then we would send our messenger to the bank and then cash it. Kaya sabi ko, I realize, tama nga, no? God has been so faithful, no? Na we never missed, no? Hindi tayo nasara all these years. So from then on, sabi na hindi ako nakakatulog sa gabi, I had a very sound sleep, no? I realized that indeed God was working in our lives. From then on, our business picked up, no? We got more orders. God has demonstrated His faithfulness and goodness to us, no? We have come back to the Philippines, no? My family, we decided on our own to come back. You know, I gave 2 years notice nga sa boss ko, no? Na we like to settle here. We prefer not to raise our children up overseas, no? And we have set up our own business. Yung set up a equipment design and manufacturing business, microcontrol design technology. And we also go, no? Every now and then go through those periods of difficulties. But now we are stronger. We can say we graduated, no? Nakita namin yung goodness ng Panginoon, His faithfulness. Na every time we go through it, we say, that won't bother us anymore. God is good. God is faithful. So one of the good things that we can say we benefited through this experience, we have taught our children how the value of giving, no? I believe giving is different than tithing. Tithing kasi is a sense of like an obligation, no? Para bang you have to give, no? Kaya minsan nagtatalo whether it should be net income or gross income. I believe giving should be out of a sense of gratitude, no? For God says He loves a cheerful giver, no? And the other thing, of course, is unless we give, no? Then the word of God, no, cannot be propagated. We're so grateful of people in the past who have given, no? And that the gospel was able to reach our lives. No? To God be the glory for all this. Thank you.